Well, I guess you're never really sure, are you, when you invite choreographers to come and work with you, what the program is going to be like and how the dancers are going to react and what they're going to make together. So it's always really thrilling at this stage to feel really pleased and sure that this program is going to be a strong one.
The title of the music, of the piece of music that Scott Walker composed, is "And Who Shall Go to the Ball and What Shall Go to the Ball," which was, you know, made especially for this piece.
I think to describe Raphael's piece, I would say powerful, moving.
It's very dynamic and very fast.
It's very linear in the arms and the hands and the legs.
I think he's passionate for the extreme in the movement.
I think you have to be really fast, like, with your eye, to really get it, because I think there's so many things happening. You're like, whoa, what was that? I want to see it again, and you don't see it again.
From the beginning, it just became very exciting. Okay, this is how we could do it, or this is how we can approach it. You know, to work with dancers like Mark, you know, which is a wheelchair user, but he's just so amazing. For me, it was just an opening up, really, of possibilities.
I think all the dancers, we got a lot of relationships between us. We found out what each person had to do with all the person, even if we didn't dance together.
You know, I think I managed to dance with everyone within the company, and each person I come into contact with is a different experience. It's a different quality, a different emotion.
Great thing about Candoco's work is that although it's a repertory company, that work is made on and for and with the dancers, so they possess it. And for me, in Raphael's piece, that's something that's really, really apparent, because they're all technically pushed hard, but they don't look strained doing it. You can just see the clarity of how they've worked.
I just love the physicality of it, and it's emotionally moving, it's expressive, it's everything that I would want to do if I was back dancing.
Never knew still waters, nothing to eat and nothing to drink. Nothing for a man to do but sit around and think. Nothing for a man to do but sit around and think.
The Stepfather, which is the title of the piece, originated from the idea of a song which came from the violent femmes called the Country Death Song, which I've been listening to since I was a teenager, and I loved it, and I always thought, God, it'd be so fantastic to really to see this story. In the song, he throws his daughter down the well and then hangs himself at the end. Then I decided, well, he shouldn't be her father, I thought he should be her stepfather.
The first scene that you see is the song itself, and it's told almost like a cabaret.
We had one day workshop with him before he started with us, and he was quite set on the story, the characters, who was going to play what, which in a way was comforting because you knew where you were coming from and what you had to do.
He had like loads of pictures of people from the Appalachian Mountains, and they're really strong characters, and he asked us all to like choose a picture and then describe the person that was in it, like basically build a story around that person.
The character affects the movement in the sense that you have to walk like a character. I don't go on a stage walking like Nadia, I go on the stage walking like her.
If you like a ukulele lady, ukulele lady like a you. If you like to linger where it's shady, ukulele lady, linger too. If you kiss a ukulele lady while you promise ever to be true, and she see another ukulele lady fool around with you.
We had a lot of fun improvising and finding these characters, and I must say the company had been fantastic in exploring these characters and letting it out. The big theme of the piece, I would say, is isolation. And anywhere where you get isolation, there's a desperation and search for attention.
As a dancer, everyone excited about touring, especially until you get to tour internationally and nationally as well.
I'm so excited. I want to get out of the studio and I want to put it on the stage.
In programming terms, I think Candoco have for a long time had very high artistic programs that they put together. So you get work that's very well produced. The dancers are great. And because it's mixed bills, I think both for the audiences and for the programmers, you get to see a real range, and this program's no different for that. There's something really theatrical and then something that's working in a very different sort of vein. And I think it lets the audiences see the diversity and make up their choices, and I think it allows for a lot of discussion after shows, which is always good to have that provocation.
Candoco's education work is absolutely about celebrating the individual and their creative potential. And what's great this year is that we have a company of very diverse dancers, each individually come from really, really different dance backgrounds and bring something very unique to the company. So with the two amazing works that we have from Rafael and Arthur at completely different ends of the spectrum in terms of dance, we've got a really broad palette that we can offer people in terms of our education work. So whether you're a school group with no experience in dance whatsoever, or a dance student or a professional, there's something for everybody this year that comes out of this really, really vibrant mix.
Expect the unexpected, really. That's what's really nice about Candoco's work, is that we really try and do different kinds of work for each new program. Both pieces will have a huge impact.
But I just want the audience to go like, wow. I want them to feel something.